focuses on 100 years of how Indian modern and contemporary art has depicted the woman in different ways, from both the male gaze and obviously the female artists, starting from the Ravi Varma works and the Western academic style with Durandar, Heman Mozumdar, then moving on to the Bengal school with Chugtai, Nandlal Bose, then basically the Europeanism of Amita Shergill, the National Art Treasures of Jamni Roy, then moving on to post-independence India, and suddenly you have Padamsi, Souza, different artists. And then you have different areas of how the woman is depicted. So whether we look behind us here, Vivan Sundaram's interpretation of emergency. So Indira Gandhi has this iconic form that sort of slowly cages human freedoms. Wazim Kapoor's depiction of the woman as seen through her own protections and regulations and religious trappings. Then various female artists, from Devyani Krishna to Jaya Ganguly to Vasudha Tiwari to Rekha Vatvidya, Pooja Irana, Bharti Kher, 50 years of the female vision of abstraction. Now, in art, the highest form of art is seen to be the abstract forms, where only the language of art speaks. So most people in our country don't understand abstraction in art. They see just empty forms, one color, forms which don't have a very clear reality. But that's the highest way of slowly surrendering to the language of art. So the woman artist has been a very bold proponent of abstraction. So you know, there's only so much you can do here. So this exhibition complements the larger exhibition, which is on cinema, which is going on at Oceanama in Liberty. So the objective is, how do you bring cinema, which is for the people of the masses, and the fine arts, which is elitist, exclusive, for a very small community? And how do you build new bridges between these two worlds? And that's been the journey for the last 20 years. It takes time, it's very difficult. But slowly, slowly, as those bridges nurture, you realize so many of the problems we are facing today is because of the lack of those bridges. The people can interfere in freedoms, they can change histories, they can interfere in daily life, because the bridge between the intelligentsia, the creative world, the financial world, the mass communication, these are very weak bridges in India, therefore very easily abused. So one of the objectives of this is to reach that wider audience, and womanhood is that main theme. It's the first theme in our calendar. The whole 18-month calendar will be open next week, and you'll see how we move forward step by step. I come from a very old school of thinking, where I feel all great knowledge, creativity, education should be free. It's a birthright. I've been fortunate to have the best education in my life, and in a country like ours, I genuinely have never believed that education should be paid for or knowledge should be paid for. In today's world, when you have new technologies, when so much is already created, you just have to find the right platforms to share with the world. It takes time. It is a very difficult process. There are many hurdles. And in our country, we've got a very hypocritical attitude that if something is free, it must be bad. So people like to pay. It's a very nasty habit on one level. At the same time, there are many people who expect everything free. So both of these are difficult worlds to balance. In Oceanama, you're seeing the best of world cinema free. And there's a huge cost for us. We have to pay entertainment tax. We have to pay hundreds of thousands of dollars to bring the prints into India. And still we are trying to make it free, even after so much financial difficulty. But it's important because the sensitivity of our people will only change when they're exposed. And today the kind of exposure we have is a very poor quality exposure. And you need to counter that with the kind of experience we are trying to share. If you see every idea that India has struggled with, the artist has tried to struggle with. You see, from the folk and tribal experiences of a woman, political comment of the artist, religious ideas, ideas of the Himalayas, nature, the role of humans in nature, sexuality and individual identity. Over there, the idea of the myth, the erotic, the sensuous, everything to do with inner journey. So art has its own language. It tackles all the things that people want to tackle. But because the language is very elitist, it's not understood by the masses. So let's say when we have mass communications through electronic media, we've got some major channels here. Now, unless they come to exhibitions, most people are afraid to come into exhibitions. They think this is not for me. They prefer to walk on Marine Drive or to walk the streets doing nothing because they are afraid to enter that space. You have to change those rules. So, you know, it takes time. It's taken 20 years before mass media is interested in art. When I started, mass media was not interested. There were a few journalists, a few art critics. It was not something that the middle classes or the working classes were interested in. That's taken nearly 15 years to change. So, you know, that whole attitude with cinema supporting the arts, with architecture supporting the arts, dance, music, performing arts, literature, philosophy, poetry. This is one family. People have forgotten that the creative mind is one family. And then slowly we specialize. It was like science. There was no biology, no physics, no chemistry, no molecule biology, no psychology. It was all one world. Slowly it becomes a very complicated world. So look, what we are trying to do is bring the whole family of creativity to our students, to the connoisseurs, to the professionals, to the middle classes, and say, look, this is your birthright. You need to understand it, whether you are poor or whether you are rich, whether you have a good education or you have no education. All of you are creative people. Every one of us is first and foremost a creative individual. Experience that creativity, bring it to the surface, and from that your freedom will come. Once you have your creativity, no one can take away that freedom. And that's the battle that India is fighting more than ever today. So, you know, it's a difficult battle. It takes time. We'll see. ये वुमनहुड का जो एक्सिबिशन है इसमें 100 साल की इतिहास जर्नी चल रही है रवि वर्मा से हेमंत मुजुमदार तक अमिता शेगिल जामनी रॉय नंदलाल बोस जो एकेडमिक स्टाइल था फिर जो बंगाल स्टाइल जो अजंता अपने पहाड़ी मिनिएचर्स इट गोज बैक टू इट्स एंशिएंट कल्चर मेडिवल कल्चर उनसे इंस्पिरेशन लिया था आप बाद में जाके देखना कि राधा कृष्णा के दो थीम्स हैं एक चुट्टाई का है एक दुरंधर का है एक बंगाल स्कूल के स्टाइल में है एक वेस्टर्न एकेडमिक के स्टाइल में है और दोनों का जो एनर्जी है वो बोध से अलग है तो 1900 जब राजा रवि वर्मा पहले आगे बढ़ रहे थे उसके बाद में बंगाल स्कूल आया उसके बाद में शांति निकेतन रविंद्रनाथ ठाकुर का स्कूल आया उसके बाद में इंडिपेंडेंस तो सूजा अकबर पदमसी बहुत से आर्टिस्ट आए और नया एटीट्यूड शुरू हुआ उसके बाद धीरे धीरे फीमेल आर्टिस्ट को मौका मिला जो हमारा शोविनिस्टिक सिस्टम है पहले ज़माने में आप सिनेमा में भी देखिए कि फीमेल एक्ट्रेसेस नहीं थे आदमी फीमेल के रोल में पोर्ट्रे करना पड़ता था आर्टिस्ट भी मैनी women artists only started really, Amita Shegel was not really Indian. She came from Hungary. She had an upper class background. Therefore, she got her acknowledgement. But after independence, mostly the Indian artists emerged. So, aapko Devyani Krishna nazar aayegi. She and her husband, Kanwal Krishna, they were the head of the modern school. So, modern school ka art department unhone banaya. Then came artists like Shobha Bhutta, Nasreen Mohammadi, Navjot, Rekha Watvidya. And then by the 80s, many women started becoming artists. And that whole movement started gaining credibility, where today, women artists are virtually equal in numbers, in opportunities with the male artists. And this whole idea of separating by gender is not so important in the world of modern and contemporary art. आपको समझना चाहिए कि मॉडर्न और कंटेम्प्रेरी आर्ट का जो अपॉर्चुनिटी बेस है, बिकॉज इट्स अ स्मॉल वर्ल्ड, छोटा सा दुनिया है, इसलिए इनजस्टिस इज नॉट सो डीप एज वी हैव इन अदर एरियाज लाइक सिनेमा. इन सिनेमा द इनजस्टिस इज वेरी डीप, द अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर द वुमेन आर फार लेस, इवन दो ऑन द 7th we are showing a special screening of, let's say, Jai Ganga Jal. Now, this time Priyanka is playing the role which Ajay Devgan played later, but it's taken nearly 40-50 years for the woman to have the kind of lead role in where she is as much an action personality as the man is. So these things take time to change. So jo Osiya Nama Liberty mein chal raha hai, world cinema ke upar, ki hum अपनी एजुकेशन, अपनी लर्निंग सिनेमा से कैसे करें, और नॉट जस्ट इंडियन सिनेमा बट वर्ल्ड सिनेमा, और ये एक्सेस हम अपने जनता को कैसे दें. तो यू नो, फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम द ग्रेटेस्ट मूवीज इन द वर्ल्ड आर बीइंग शोन फ्री इन वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट सिनेमाज इन द वर्ल्ड, नॉट जस्ट द ग्रेटेस्ट सिनेमा इन इंडिया, देयर आर 5 to 10 ग्रेट आर्ट डेको सिनेमाज लेफ्ट इन द वर्ल्ड. लिबर्टी इज वन ऑफ दोज ग्रेट सिनेमाज, एंड टू सी एंड टू एक्सपीरियंस देयर, there's a different energy. So obviously we are trying to build new bridges. Hindi mein, baba meri hindi itni tooti phooti hai, lekin koshish karta hu. Jo bridge ko kya bolte hain hindi mein, pull, jo pull hum mass creativity aur elite creativity mein banana chahte hain, wo cinema aur fine arts mein ban raha hai. Ye cheez hamare desh mein pehle se nahi hai. आप देखोगे कि वर्किंग क्लास और मिडिल क्लास ज़्यादा से एक ही एंटरटेनमेंट फॉर्म उनका है, और वो है सिनेमा, और वो भी मेन स्ट्रीम सिनेमा जो हम बहुत गलत तरीके से बॉलीवुड बुलाते हैं. अब वर्ल्ड सिनेमा जो है फ्रॉम ओवर 125 कंट्रीज जो हम इंट्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं अपनी जनता के लिए, फ्रॉम अफ्रीका, फ्रॉम एशिया, ईरान, फ्रॉम लैटिन अमेरिका, कंट्रीज जो लोगों ने पहले देखा भी नहीं है, जो समझो आप चाइल्ड म्यूटिलेशन के ऊपर जो सिनेमा बनवा है, लेकिन आप अफ्रीकन सिनेमा देखिए तो वहाँ का जो म्यूटिलेशन ट्रेडिशन है वो आगे बन चुका है, कि आज औरत बोलती है कि हमें म्यूटिलेशन अच्छा लगता है क्योंकि ये हमारा ट्रेडिशन है, हमें फ्रीडम देना चाहिए कि हमें चूज करना है कि हमें म्यूटिलेशन चाहिए, ये हमारा हक है. Obviously, that is different from child mutilation. But today, the nature of the debate has become much more complicated. So, unless you experience world cinema and you see that different countries are, there are different stages of the journey, whether it is child abuse, whether it is child marriage, whether it is domestic violence, whether it is rape, whether it's prostitution, whether it is inheritance laws, abortion rights, all of these special challenges jo females and the ladies face and the children and the girls face, unless you are exposed to the global journey, you will not be able to tackle it within India. So that is why world cinema is a very fundamental part of that education process.
Exhibition mein jo mahatvakari cheez yeh hai ki mahila ko itna mahatvapurna भाव दिया है, और मैं समझती हूँ कि महिलाएं सबसे दे फॉर्म द बैकबोन ऑफ आर सोसाइटी, वही है जो बच्चों को तौर तरीके संस्कार देती है, जो आगे बच्चे पढ़ के हमारी समाज के सेवक होते हैं, और इनको अच्छा आचार विचार होते हैं तभी हमारी समाज आगे बढ़ सकती है. महिलाओं का इस हिसाब से बहुत महत्वपूर्ण कर्तव्य और महिमा होती है हमारी समाज में. ये एग्जिबिशन में बहुत अच्छी एग्जिबिशन है जिसमें दिखाया है कि औरतों का कितना स्ट्रॉन्ग स्वभाव भावनाएं होती हैं अपनी समाज में, और ये ज़्यादा करके हमारे देश में ये ज़्यादा महत्वकांक्षी है, जबकि सब चीज़ पुरुष के ही लिए कही जाती है, उन्हीं को ज़्यादा महिमा दी जाती है. अभी भी गांव में और छोटे शहरों में औरतों का बहुत कम इज्जत होती है, तो ये एग्जिबिशन थोड़े हमारे भावनाओं में, हमारे विचारों में हमें बहुत ज़्यादा सोचने का तरीका देते हैं कि औरतों को भी इज्जत करनी चाहिए।
बहुत ही खूबसूरत तरीके से एक आर्टिस्टिक वे में ओसियानामा ने 100 ईयर्स ऑफ वुमेनहुड को कैप्चुलाइज किया है पेंटिंग फॉर्म के थ्रू, और बड़ी खूबसूरती से, और ये दिखाना कि इंडियन वुमन एट इट्स प्राइम। आज इतना डिबेट है कि वल्गैरिटी ओब्सिनिटी, लेकिन खूबसूरती से जो वुमेन की खूबसूरती इन पेंटिंग्स ने, चाहे वो अमृता शेरगिल की हो या सूजा की हो या बंगाल स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट जो कि लेके आज के कॉन्टेम्प्रेरी आर्ट तक जो इस पेंटिंग्स का डिस्प्ले है, राजा रवि वर्मा की जो एथनिक ब्यूटी है इन पेंटिंग्स के थ्रू दिखाया है कि वुमेन की एसेंस जो एक ब्यूटी है वो पेंटिंग्स में दिखाया है, और लाइफ विच मीन्स वुमेन इस पेंटिंग से साफ दिखता है कि वुमेन इन इट्स ब्यूटिफुल फॉर्म्स, चाहे वो एक पर्दे में हो, चाहे एक बुरके में हो या अपने आभूषणों में हो, लेकिन महिला की जो नारी शक्ति है इन पेंटिंग्स में ओसियानामा ने पूरी क्लियरली डिस्प्ले करी है।